Good morning, everybody, and welcome back to another weather forecast here by Adrian of the Forecast. As you guys can tell, this is going to be my summer preliminary winter, my first preliminary summer forecast here. So, I was actually going to do this a bit earlier on, but I just didn't get to make my maps, but I finally made them last weekend. So, hope you guys do enjoy this again. This is not 100% accurate. This is just based on using far out models and just all of that. So I do apologize if this is not 100% accurate, but this is the best and the most probably this is like the best I probably feel about these maps here. But if you are new to the channel, be sure to subscribe, guys. We are so close to 2,210 subscribers. We just need three more. So please hit the subscribe button. I do daily weather forecasts. I will have another update on the incredibly strong wind shear, wind gusts, severe weather, and flash flooding in the mid-Atlantic and Northeast. That will be video later this earlier this a early this afternoon. So be sure to stay tuned for that. Also, be sure to share the channel to any friends or family so we can help grow this channel a lot more. And also, of course, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. But without further ado, let's get into the summer forecast. So here's the precipitation here. So as you can tell, we have on the top right, or sorry, the top left, above average. As you can tell, you can just see the colors to see exactly how much or how much more above average precipitation you'll see. And same thing with the top right with the below average precipitation. So let's go ahead and start off with the above average precipitation. So in this lighter shaded green, kind of lime green color, that's where we have slightly above average precipitation. So we're expected to see of course more precipitation, but it won't be necessarily a lot more, really. Maybe a couple inches more, 5 maybe 6 inches more than your average, or maybe even a little bit more as it's the whole season. So that's gonna be mostly for those areas. I can see a lot more severe weather here. So this is mainly gonna be rain from severe weather. So we're gonna be seeing a ton of more severe weather outbreaks, possibly in the plains, the Midwest, maybe in the mid-Atlantic, which can bring in a bit more precipitation. So that's where we expected a little bit more precipitation than usual summers. And now time for the darker shade of green. That's moderately above average precipitation. So there's a better chance and a better chance for way more precipitation. Now that's gonna be in that darker green color. That can also be from this can be most likely from tropical systems, tropical disturbances, maybe hurricanes, tropical storms, tropical depressions, any of those, maybe even invests just off the coast. That'll bring in a ton of rain for the Gulf Coast and also the Southeast, like Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina. And of course, if we have any hurricane landfalls, tropical storms, that'll just move in a little bit down to areas such as Virginia, Kentucky, Tennessee, Missouri, Arkansas, as those systems do. Wherever they make landfall, we'll bring in a very widespread rain, just a little bit more inland. So obviously, it won't bring in that incredibly amount of rain for the Midwest or plains. It'll be just those areas that aren't too far from, or not incredibly far from, the coastal areas and all that. And also, of course, not only that, but we'll be seeing a lot of severe weather in these areas as well. Maybe we'll seeing possibly tropical like sys or tropical systems that could bring a lot of rain for the Gulf, even a bit more inland, and also severe weather. Looks like we'll definitely be seeing a lot more severe weather, of course, in the summer. So definitely be seeing a lot more rain. Now from the below average temperatures, or sorry, below average precipitation, we're gonna have two areas: the West, the Northwest, and the Northeast. So starting off the Northwest in that lighter shade of that light shade of brown, that's slightly below average precipitation. So we've seen obviously a lot, obviously seeing less precipitation here, so not as much rain in these areas. So it will be a bit drier. It won't be really anything really major, not any droughts. Really, just gonna be maybe 5 10 inches below average precipitation. You probably won't even notice the change, really. Same thing with the areas in the Northeast in that lighter shade. We're gonna be seeing a bit of a less precipitation there, so gonna be a little bit drier as well. And then that second shade of below average, and that second shade of brown, that's where we have moderately below average. That's gonna be for the Pacific Northwest and even Maine. That's where you possibly notice that less precipitation. That'll be a bit better of a lot more precipitation, a lot less. Now time to look at temperatures here. So we're gonna be starting off with the above average temperatures. So as you can tell, it looks like we're gonna be seeing a very warm summer throughout. Many people in the mainland United States, gonna be possibly very, very warm summer, especially throughout the general South. So all the way from the Southwest to the Southeast and even areas into the New England area. So just in general, it's looking like a very warm summer. So in that light shade of orange, that kind of lightish kind of orange, that's where you have slightly above average temperatures. So there you could possibly see on average the whole season, maybe around 3 to 5 degrees above average. Of course, we're obviously going to be seeing major warm fronts throughout these areas that are just in the slightly above average temperatures that can bring in 10 to 20 degrees above average. But that's, we're not going to be seeing enough of those major warm fronts in the exact same areas to make it on that second shade of orange. So really, for that slightly below or slightly above average temperatures, you won't necessarily, again, feel it, but it, obviously it's going to be a bit warmer. So if you're, maybe your average is 80 in June, maybe you can get up to 85 or maybe even 86 or 87 or even higher. And that second shade of orange, that's where we have our better chance for seeing above average temperatures. And it seems like it will be a bit more long-lasting in these areas. That's going to be all the way from Arizona up to Maine. So I think so the south, central, southeast, those areas are definitely going to be very warm, especially a lot of humidity here. So we're going to be seeing very warm temperatures much throughout the year. And this year we could possibly see a lot more warm fronts that can be a lot longer lasting, that can obviously the whole season average out to moderately above average temperatures. So it looks like in these areas that are in the darker shade of orange, you guys have a better chance for seeing more frequent warm fronts this summer here than the other shade of orange. And now at the below average temperatures, we will be seeing possibly cold fronts or cool downs or multiple cool downs or cold fronts out here into the northern United States. That's going to be throughout areas out here into the north central plains and parts of the Midwest. That's where we'll possibly be seeing multiple cold fronts coming in. Of course, usually in summer we have multiple cold fronts throughout the United States, but they're of course not going to be as strong as the fall ones. They're not going to be as frequent, but we will be. If we're going to have any frequent cold fronts entering the United States, it will be in the north central plains, but it won't be really, obviously, in the summer. Usually, cold fronts don't really last as long, or they don't go as much into the southeast. But again, we're still going to be, even if you're in the above average temperatures, I'm not saying you're not going to be seeing cold. You won't see one day with below average temperatures. That's going to be an average the whole season, I think 4 months, just on average, with all just at. In general, you got to be above average temperatures. Doesn't mean you're not going to have cold fronts. Of course, you're going to have a cold front or a cold front or two. So that is my temperatures. I don't think that's my temperature map. I don't think it's necessarily going to be seeing a moderately above below average area. I don't think it's necessarily going to be seeing that many cold fronts, or if we do have a lot, it won't be as strong. So it won't be maybe 10 to 20 degrees below average, maybe staying maybe 3 to 8 degrees below average. Now it's time to look at my general map here. So as you can tell, we have a lot of colors here. So I'm going to be starting off with the pink in the coastal areas. That's where we have tropical activity. So that can be hurricanes, tropical storms, depressions, any somewhat tropical activity. That's going to be likely all the way from all of the Gulf of Mexico. So all the way from Texas to Florida, even all of the Virginia. So I think Virginia, even all the way up to Virginia, we have a possibility to see any tropical activity. That doesn't necessarily mean you're going to have a landfall going right there. Let me actually switch colors. Doesn't necessarily mean you're going to be seeing direct landfall if you're in this pink. Again, this is not 100% accurate. This is just usually, it's very likely we'll be seeing tropical activity in any of these areas. Doesn't mean each state here will be getting a tropical activity. It's just on what we're possibly going to be seeing. And usually we have every summer these areas of tropical activity, but all the way in Virginia or the Carolinas doesn't mean you're necessarily going to get hit with direct landfall. It could be any tropical activity that just skins you, and that's going to be tropical activity and tropical downpours. So that's in that pink. So if you're in tropical activity, you might just want to maybe have a plan just in case. You want to have a plan if you're in the Gulf of Mexico or the East Coast in general. Maybe just get a bit more prepared, as we're looking you saw my hurricane forecast. It's going to be very, very active hurricane season, and can possibly have a wild card area in the mid-Atlantic. So the mid-Atlantic, you guys can't rule out the possibility of maybe getting hit. Now in the dark green, we have wet and humid. So that's going to be throughout much of the parts of the south central and much of the southeast and even parts of the mid-Atlantic there. So if you're in the dark green, you're going to get really, like we said, above average precipitation. You're going to be seeing either tropical systems or tropical activity bringing that rain, or severe weather. That's going to also be very humid. It's going to be really, really humid. There's going to be a lot of humidity and all of that. So that's exactly why you can obviously have severe weather, a lot more severe weather outbreaks this summer as well. So if you're in the wet and humid, it's not going to be really a fun summer necessarily, because humidity and obviously the rain kind of makes this humidity even worse. In the yellow, we have T storms or thunderstorms. So not necessarily severe weather outbreaks, but we're going to be seeing, usually as we get into June and July, we start to see these thunderstorms and severe weather, not necessarily outbreaks, but just severe weather in general, like pop-up storms, become a bit more likely in the Northeast and Ohio Valley. So that's going to be, if you're anywhere in the yellow from northern Georgia all the way up into the New York City area and New York, you'll be seeing thunderstorms likely, a lot of pop-up storms, so you can be seeing rain, maybe rain 1 minute and then the other minute no rain. So it's going to be just seeing that kind of Florida-like pattern there. And then in the dark, kind of the dark brown or the reddish brown in the New England area, that's where we have warm and dry. So it's going to be very warm and dry. It's not going to be a really fun summer for you guys because you guys are kind of used to that cool winter or that cool summers where we have that kind of cold fronts coming in from Ontario and all that. But it's going to be a bit of a warmer summer there for the New England area. So a little break from this cold air. In the red, we have severe weather outbreaks. So that's this is the area. This is where we'll be seeing outbreaks, not just pop-up thunderstorms. This is going to be the area we have focus on for outbreaks. And as we get closer into May, June, that's where we'll be seeing the Midwest and the Central Plains getting a lot more active. March and April is usually Southeast and Dixie Alley, but now the Midwest, this is your time to shine here for severe weather. So any area from Wisconsin, Minnesota, all the way to Oklahoma and Arkansas, you guys are going to be seeing severe weather outbreaks likely. It can be multiple. It can be maybe huge ones. I can't exactly say the date or how bad they will be, but it's very likely to be seeing severe weather outbreaks. In the purplish color, we have extreme heat. And that's going to be seeing, I know some of those areas weren't in the darker shade of orange, but we're going to be seeing very big warm fronts. And this doesn't mean exactly we're going to be seeing 20 degrees above average for some of these years. We obviously will with some warm fronts. Sometimes we see 30 degrees above average every year in parts of Texas. But these averages in these areas in Oklahoma, Texas, New Mexico, Arizona, even parts of the desert areas of Colorado, Utah, you guys see very warm averages already in midsummer. And with these frequent cold fronts in these areas, or frequent warm fronts in these areas, you guys are going to be seeing extreme heat. Definitely be seeing triple digits throughout these areas. So very likely we're going to be seeing very warm weather here. Now into the gray, we have average. So couldn't really find anything to put there. I was going to put flip-flop, but I just thought it would be average because you guys aren't going to be seeing necessarily above average precipitation, below average precipitation, above average temperatures, or below average temperatures. You guys are going to kind of stay just at a little average summer. So you guys are going to be seeing kind of just the same that you usually see. So that's going to be the average. So I do apologize if you're in the average and you were hoping for something else, but that's the best I can come up with. And in the blue color, we have a cooler summer. So I was actually a bit colder summer, but it's not going to be cold. So it's going to be cool. Because we won't be seeing very major cold fronts. That can be very frequent. And that's where we're going to be seeing these severe weather outbreaks in the Midwest and also into the Central Plains. Because with the incoming cold fronts and possibly the humidity and all that moisture in the Gulf, that's a perfect area for severe weather. So if it weren't for these cold fronts in the North Central Plains, they wouldn't maybe see as many severe weather outbreaks here. And then in the orange, we have very warm. I actually forgot to put the kind of the background black on that on those letters, but that's gonna be seeing very warm. That's usually where we it's sad to say that almost every summer, we usually see the Southwest under some very warm. But that's gonna be out there into the areas in Southwest and even to the South Central, stretching all the way to Oklahoma. Could be very warm, but not necessarily, I wouldn't say necessarily extreme heat, because obviously we see very warm temperatures, and sadly, some of these areas in Arizona, California, Nevada, and Utah are used to seeing triple digits every year from warm fronts, and that's kind of sad. But that's going to be seeing very warm temperatures. And then in the Pacific Northwest there, or in general the Northwest, we have much drier. So that's going to be mainly for the Washington, Oregon area where it's much drier, but in general it's going to be a lot drier out there into the West. I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm planning on having my May forecast coming out tomorrow. I gotta finish up one map and then I'm good to go. So be sure to stay tuned for that. Again, subscribe if you are new to the channel. I will have another video out there later this afternoon, early afternoon on the Mid-Atlantic and on the Northeast with all those topics we need to talk about. Bye guys, stay safe.